Hi again, and this time we'll talk about layout.
A layout is a floor plan. Layouts exist at different granularities. A macro layout shows the relative positioning of buildings and departments. A micro layout shows how production equipment, storage, transport, and open space is organized. Deciding the layout is a strategic decision with significant impact on running costs.
There are at least three reasons why any company should take layout decisions seriously. First, layout is important for process efficiency and dictates inventories and flows of materials between processes. Hence, it has a significant impact on company costs. Second, layout affects the working environment, the physical movements, the lights and interaction between people. Hence, it has a large impact on the workers' safety and well-being. Third, layout is usually a one-off long-term investment, which may be unchanged for several decades. Hence, it dictates strategies and basically decides what you can do with your factory.
Layout has been a topic of great interest in the history of POM, and there are many everyday examples that you would be familiar with. For example, in the 1920s, Lillian Gilbreth, an industrial engineering pioneer, designed, among other things, hospital operating rooms and the modern kitchen. These designs are essentially about layout, the placement of processes in a building or a room. Together with her husband Frank, Lillian used detailed time and motion studies to identify the best relative placement of machines, people, and equipment.
We separate three generic types of layout: functional layout, product layout, and fixed position layout. Let me explain.
The functional layout organizes similar processes in the same area. For example, many hospitals organize their layout according to specialities, such as cardiology, internal medicine, and neuroscience, or according to their support functions, such as labs and radiology. In manufacturing, many low-volume, high-mix factories still have job shops with specialized equipment organized in the same rooms. Often, process constraints leave no other option than to organize processes in a functional layout. An example is painting booths. The functional layout has several benefits. It increases the ability to handle large variation in processing needs. It allows the creation of centers of expertise, and it is less vulnerable to changes in product mix and volume or machine breakdowns. Some drawbacks related to functional layouts are that they hinder flow and hence are often less productive. They create large buffers of work in progress. They can lead to low degree of resource utilization, and they make it difficult to identify errors. In fact, when analyzing the flow patterns in this type of layout, we usually get what we call spaghetti diagrams. It looks like a pot of cooked spaghetti, impossible to navigate. Product layouts are organized with an eye to the product flows. The typical examples are assembly lines or U-cells. In product layouts, machines are set up linearly to produce one product group. It utilizes standard processes to create efficient flow and high volume output. It is especially suitable for standardized products, high production volumes, and stable production quantities. Among the benefits of product layouts are a low specialization of the workforce in few and well-defined tasks, which simplifies training and control. The layout type also allows logical flows, low material handling cost, and efficient utilization of labor and equipment. The established material flows inform production planning and scheduling and reduce the buffer levels needed between processes. But process layouts also have limitations. They have little flexibility in volume changes and speed, requires reorganization for new and different product groups, can create dull and repetitive work, and is vulnerable to breakdowns. It also requires large investment in necessary equipment. Finally, we have the fixed position layout. In this layout type, the product is stationary, and workers, materials, and production equipment are relocated to the product as required. Examples are large construction projects such as buildings, dams, oil platforms, or shipbuilding. But also heavy machines or some airplane factories would use this type of layout. Fixed position layout is often used when products are large and heavy, fragile, vulnerable, or difficult to handle and move. However, it has a very complex material flow, which makes planning and scheduling a tricky task. Very generally, we can get an idea of the right layout by looking at Hayes and Wheelwright's famous product process matrix. On the horizontal axis, we have the volume of products, and on the vertical axis, we have the degree of flow. Hayes and Wheelwright separated 5 process types in manufacturing: project, job shop, batch, assembly line, and continuous production. Generally speaking, the fixed position layout is most applicable in the upper left corner, project manufacturing. The functional layout is typically found in job shops and batch production, and the product layout is most applicable in assembly line and continuous flow designs.
So now you know something about layout. This seemingly trivial concept is anything but. Having the skills to analyze layouts and design new ones is a critical skill for a manufacturing engineer. The suitable location of machines, equipment, and rooms changes when there are changes in product mix and volumes, or when there are new certification requirements, for example, environmental regulations, or when new equipment is bought and installed. Is the layout of your apartment tailored to your need?